People,
it's a Friday.
It is indeed
Friday.
Your boy Neo
And
and Legu speaking about cash flow.
Flowing.
Cash is king.
How is that money flowing in
That's
your
our
account?
favorite topic, by the way. Cash flow. The way I love it so much.
Yeah.
I'm thinking of naming my daughter Cash and my son Flo. Together they would definitely be flowing.
No world. Okay, cash flow. What do you understand by the term cash flow? Right? So now, I've read up that the two most important things that rich people actually use to become rich, it's taxes and credit, right? So now, in our cash flow topic, I would actually like to talk about credit first, right? Credit could be the most powerful thing.
And it can also be the most
worst thing,
detrimental tool towards your path.
It could break you down. That's why the reason for starting with cash, with credit, is that we actually wanted to talk about self-awareness.
Yeah.
Do you know yourself? Do you know yourself as far as, are you going to be able to actually use money which is borrowed to you from a credit facilities in a right way, right? I'm not talking about actually borrowing money to go live a lifestyle, right? Which actually wouldn't get you that cash flow.
Because at the end of the day, this is a relationship with you and money.
Yeah.
Now, if you have that relationship with money, because everybody does have a relationship with money, whether you like it or not. So now what we need to establish is, are you investing in liabilities or assets?
Are you able to handle a credit amount given by a credit facility?
Because now when we're dealing with credit, you need to understand that the money that I'll be using, will it be with regards to increasing my assets or increasing my liabilities?
So I pose the question to you. Do you really know yourself? Would you be willing to manage, say, 100K? Would you be willing to manage 1 million?
Of credit.
Let's talk about entrepreneurship. Sir.
With regards to entrepreneurship, I think there's so much buzz these days of everybody wanting to become an entrepreneur. But my question is, do people really understand what does entrepreneurship mean? Because I think entrepreneurship is one of the most hardest fields that one can go into. Because I mean, you're starting your own game. And when we're talking about starting your own game, you have to make your own rules, your own systems that will actually lead towards your goals. Are we ready, or does the term entrepreneurship intrigue us so much that we get in love with it? We tell people that I'm self-employed and that I'm actually doing things on my own. Do we really understand the fundamentals of entrepreneurship?
I like how you talked about entrepreneurship, because now we also have people who are also self-employed, right? Mm-hmm. Remember, if you're self-employed, you're actually creating a job for yourself,
okay.
Right? So now with an entrepreneur, it's that you're creating systems in place for the business to work, be it that you're there or not there. Right? So now that's the difference between the two. Don't get it mixed
up. So in other words, are you trying to tell me that self-employed can actually be destructive because now the business cannot operate without me? I need to be there full-time.
It could be destructive to you. Say, for example, you're a doctor, right? Yeah. And you have a surgery, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you're the only doctor that actually works there.
Yeah, yeah.
What happens when you get sick? What happens when you get involved in a car accident? That monthly cash flow stops, right? Whereas if you're an entrepreneur, you actually set systems in place whereby if you are absent from the workspace, the business is able to actually work with or without you.
Wow. So at the end of the day, it's clear that when you're stepping into the entrepreneurship game, that you have to set systems, set powerful systems that will work to your advantage and the growth of the business. Because I think also another detrimental thing that happens with us as entrepreneurs is that we always focused on the end goal. And most of the time, for the fact that I said the end goal, The end goal is not near. So now we'll be saying that, okay, by next year I want to drive and the latest sports car. The following year I want to buy an apartment in the north. However, we're not focusing on the processes that will actually lead towards it. Because I mean, money is important. Making money is important. That's what sustains the business. However, are we so focused on the end goal that we lose in touch, we lose touch of the processes?
So now, my advice to you guys, the entrepreneur, is that if you're going to be actually creating a business, right, try to create a system in place that works with or without you. Because now remember what we said earlier on is that once you create a business which needs you to be always there, you are now self-employed, right? You created employment for yourself, which is not bad, right? But now it depends on you. If you're doing this for cash flow, for monthly cash flow, you'd rather set a system in place whereby it operates with or without you.
This is what every entrepreneur needs to hear. You need to set proper systems in place and you need to work with the end goal in mind. What do I mean when I'm saying end goal in mind? If you know that you want to have signed 80,000 clients in your company, then you look at your weekly targets. You break it down towards the bigger goal. So for instance, if you know that by end of this year, I want to have reached 80,000. So now you're going to look how many months you have towards that target, and then you're going to break it down to the weeks. You're going to break it down to the days. Through that, you'll be working chronologically towards the end goal in mind. So it's important to have the end goal in mind, divide it on a daily basis so that you know that you have tasks that will lead you to the result that you had before.
I mean, it could be overwhelming to actually hear that 80,000. But now think about it. If you actually take the clients, the number of clients that you actually had signed from the time you actually started until now, you might see that it was a large sum. It goes back to the story that we always hear that you can't eat an elephant at one time, right? You actually have to actually dice it up first and eat it day by day, right? So now same thing with this. You set big goals and then you divide them up daily and then you actually get how many people you have to close every day. Guys,
Let's like, share, subscribe.
see you next week, Monday.
Secret exposed.